Hello friends! In this video I will be showing you the Ecoline brush pens for hand lettering. These are a watercolor brush pen and I think that lots of people love them because they are very juicy. The tip is nice and flexible and gives a very thick downstroke when you press down firmly, but you can also get a nice upstroke as well. You can see in this lettering example that they are taking a bit of time to dry, and when they do dry they have a bit of watercolor look to them, where there's quite a color difference between a thick downstroke and a thin upstroke, and I think that's because the upstroke is just quite a bit less concentrated with the liquid watercolor. But these are really beautiful and really unique if you like those really, really thick, juicy downstrokes. So even after all of that lettering, there are still quite a few spots that are wet and would streak pretty easily, so just be careful about that. These blend beautifully in my opinion. You really could get creative with your color combining or do like one color per letter. I am not someone who does a ton of blending in my own lettering, so I'm sorry this isn't super creative, but I hope it helps by giving you an idea of what this brush pen blends like. I didn't have a ton of space to letter horizontally with that first blending example, but imagine if you wrote out a long word or across more room and your word kind of gradually went from one color and faded into another. That would be a really fun way to blend these. So I hope you don't mind that I'm not using these straight onto watercolor paper. But with delicate brush pens and hand lettering, that can be kind of a bad combination because the brush pens tend to fray. You might think since they're watercolor markers that you should only use them on watercolor paper, and if you're coloring with them, that may not be that big of a deal. But for hand lettering, it can be hard to create those thin upstrokes if you have frayed brush pens. But they do dry beautifully onto watercolor paper, so I wanted to show you a way to use them on watercolor paper without ruining the brush tips. In this example, I'm coloring the marker onto a piece of acrylic. You could use ceramic or plastic, and then I'm picking it up with my water brush. You could also just use a wet paintbrush as well. Then I can letter right onto the watercolor paper, and I really think this is super beautiful, and as somebody who doesn't have a lot of practice blending, I was really impressed with how beautifully these colors came out. I feel like I need to try this more in the future. I do assume that if you were to letter right onto watercolor paper, that the colors would be darker like in my lettering example. But I also love this muted look and you could really get a range of colors and tones with it. If you are looking for the Winsor & Newton watercolor brush marker review, I am going to link that one in the description box below so that you can compare the two if you're interested in using watercolor markers for hand lettering. Thanks for watching and I'll see you in that video!